I saw in one of the YouTube comments where someone said, "SkillCapped, how do we know what our win condition is?" This is a good question, because it can be hard to figure out what that is in a solo queue scenario, where you can't rely on teammates to do their jobs. So when thinking about win conditions, you should always be focusing on what is your solo win condition. What do you have to do to carry this game on your own? Today's video is going to be two parts. The first part, we're going to talk about general win conditions based off champion pick and team comp, and the second part, I will use an example of a game where I stick to my win condition, when a lot of players would be tempted to stray away from it, and you'll see what I mean when we get there. Before we even start, what is a win condition? It basically just means the scenario you need to win the game. It can be something as simple as, do you want a team fight or split push? But it gets more advanced than that. So let's talk about realizing your win condition. Let's start with an obvious one. If one team has Kennen top, Fiddle jungle, Orianna mid, Kog'Maw ADC and Lulu support, and the other has Irelia top, Yasuo mid, Kayn jungle, Sivir ADC and Karma support, the first team's win condition would obviously be team fighting, while the second team would be split pushing. This is the case in a perfect world, like a professional scenario. But we all know that's not how it works in solo queue. This is where things get tricky, so let's take it from the top, literally. Kennen's solo queue win condition would be to be strong enough that he can flash on the backline and kill multiple targets or the main carry. If he's not strong enough to do that, he would be useless. He doesn't win side lane versus split pusher like Irelia. We get more in depth here, but this is the general idea of a solo queue win condition. Then for Fiddle, his win condition is similar to Kennen, where he wants to get really fed to kill the backline. But something equally important, if not more important, is that he needs to have vision control of the area he'll be fighting in, whether that's Dragon, Baron, or a lane. Moving to Orianna, Ori is a mage, so obviously she wants to be strong enough to carry a teamfight with her ult. But something equally important is not dying to ganks or roams in mid so she can constantly wave clear and keep mid towers up. For some mages, like Anivia, that's her main win condition, keep mid tier 1 tower up. For Lulu and Kog'Maw, we're just going to pair them since this would get very complicated and take a while. But Lulu and Kog is a pretty obvious one. Kog doesn't need to win lane, he just needs to survive and farm long enough that he gets some items and Lulu tries to keep him alive. For the other team, Irelia needs to be fed enough that she wins 1v1 or even 1v2 in a side lane. Why is that important though? Well, it's not that she needs to kill them exactly, it's that she needs the pressure in a side lane. If she pushes the wave first because the enemy top or mid can't stop her from doing it, then she has a tempo advantage, which basically means she can rotate first and start a numbers up fight. Or she can straight up dive the enemy top or mid if she's that fed. This same win condition would apply to Yasuo in a game like this or any other assassin like Zed, Fizz, or Ekko. Kayn wants to skirmish as much as possible, meaning 2v2s and 3v3s. Against a heavy teamfighting comp like that, he doesn't want to just group in 5v5. To find 2v2s and 3v3s, you play around your split pushers. They split and he hovers near them for a counter gank, or dives the enemy laner that's pushed in. Then, Sivir and Karma have a simple job in a game like this, and that's to wave clear mid while the split pushers push. This makes it so the enemy can't just force a teamfight and play to their win condition, and they actually have to respond to the pressure from the split push. And by doing this and farming properly, Sivir can scale up and carry fights later as an ADC because that's when ADCs have the most impact. But you may be thinking at this point, what if my solo laners are losing and aren't pushing? Or what if my Sivir doesn't clear waves and they die in mid? Exactly, it's solo queue and some people won't do their jobs. But the important thing is that you do your job and know your win condition. So now I'm going to show you an example of a game that I played in Gold 1 where I know my win condition and stick to it. I don't let teammates bait me into doing things I know I shouldn't be doing. In this game, I'm playing a Lowy mid for Sylas. This is both team comps. My team comp isn't as important as the enemy one though. Because as a Lowy, the more melee champions they have, the easier it is to 1v2, 1v3, or even 1v4. A Lowy is an easy champion to explain win conditions with because it's very clear what she does. She either falls behind and is completely useless, or she gets fed and can 1v2 or 1v3 if the situation is right. So the first part of my win condition for me this game is to win lane, and I picked a Lowy into Sylas as a counterpick. I never blind pick her, meaning I should win if playing properly. Playing properly means not pushing before level 6 too much, as Lowy is very easy to gank without her ult, and I didn't push till level 5.5, and the moment I did, I got ganked and killed. I had 35 CS to Sylas 17 though, so we'll be about even in gold when I get back. Now I'm level 6, meaning I can actually start laning without being too afraid of Hecarim as long as my E and ult are up. I just want to shove the wave, then look to land E's on Sylas. Doing this will poke Sylas and set up tentacles around him, while putting a lot of pressure on the lane. This should make Hecarim want to gank me, which I can easily 1v2 if I play it right. After dropping a ward on bot side, notice I don't even clear the enemy control ward. This is because Sylas is farming under tower right now, which is my win condition for the lane, and I don't want to waste this time where I can be poking him or looking for E pulls. When I go to use W on this minion, this baits Sylas into jumping in on me, so I land an easy E next to this tentacle I've set up. If I ulted here, I could potentially kill him, but if I don't kill him, I can't pressure anymore without being in danger of dying to ganks. So instead, I'll just take the big chunk on Sylas and hold the ult because Hecarim will definitely gank me from the pressure I'm putting on at the moment. Also, with how much health Silas just lost, he has no chance at killing me anymore. I can even dive him if I want after crashing the wave. My corruption potion damage ticking on him makes me have to stay out of tower range sometimes, but he's obviously feeling the pressure at this point. And as expected, here comes Hecarim, only level 5, charging right at me. Since a lot of low-elo players think Illaoi is so OP, and will definitely think so after seeing what happens next, let's replace Illaoi here with any other champion. If I'm Orianna at level 7, with Silas at that same health, and Hecarim is jumping on me at level 5, I easily win as Ori. I can kite Hecarim, and if Silas jumps in, he just dies. If I'm Fizz or Zed or any assassin, I just one-shot the Hecarim without even needing my ult, especially if I have Ignite. So the takeaway here is, look what pressure does to the enemy jungler. He feels like he has to gank me right now, even though there's no chance of it working out no matter what champion I'm on here. And why is that important? Well, prepare yourselves, because your mind is about to be blown. Like I said, Illaoi has clear win conditions because she's the worst champ in the game. She can't roam, she can't really make TP plays, so her win condition is to shove hard like this and hope they can gank you and try to 1v2. But let's say I'm on Zed, and my bot and top are losing, so I can't make any roaming plays. I still have the win condition for lane, where I can hard pressure the lane and try to get the enemy jungler to gank me, as long as I'm ahead. Then I can just kill him like in this scenario. This is why it's so important to understand your win conditions with each game, as you can have multiple depending on the scenarios, or just one, and you really have to stick to it. Anyways, I 1v2 them of course, and now I'm level 8 to the Silas level 6, I have 60 CS, he has 27. Then a little bit later I do the exact same thing, pushing mid and making the enemy jungler gank me, and with how much gold I got from the last one, it makes me even stronger, so I 1v2 again. They actually played it alright this time though, but Hecarim died off the screen to a random tentacle. Then, with a pretty insane read on Silas, I grab his spirit here, and he doesn't know what my champion does, so he seals his fate by hitting me with the second part of his E. They eventually bring Ornn to mid instead after this, but I'm so fed it doesn't do them any good, and this lets me get first tower, so I have to think about my win conditions again. Well, we already established Illaoi doesn't roam or gank or make TP plays. Both bot and top towers are still up for both teams, so I can just keep pressuring mid. If you're wondering why I shouldn't just go to bot or top and help them take the towers, that would just let the enemy mid farm for free. There's no reason to do that when I'm fed enough where I can potentially 1v3 or 1v4. The enemy team doesn't know what to do at this point to stop me, so I take the tier 2 and keep pressuring. Eventually I use my ult here and Silas flashes away, then I recall to spend my gold. When I'm in base, I can see my team is fighting, but I don't have ult, and my champion is pretty much useless without it, so I'm not going to TP into that. I want to stick to my win condition, which is to hard pressure a lane and bring multiple members to me so my teammates can do whatever they want. They can't get caught or feed if the enemy team is too busy trying to deal with me. I start working on bot tower, which brings Kate to me, so I land an E to chunk her a bit and get some tentacle spawning. Silas shows up as well though, knowing Kate can't deal with me alone. At this point, I know more will be coming, so I need to be careful with my E. If I don't land it, I can't 1v3 or 1v4, I absolutely need it, so I'm just waiting and letting the play develop a bit. Now they are face checking the brush, so it's about to go down. I use my E on Nautilus since he's so close, and Silas is moving in a weird way, I could potentially miss on him. Now that my E is landed, I can use ult and it's party time. Sadly, right before my last Q lands on Hecarim, his Q kills me. If my Q landed, it would have healed me enough that I could W him one more time and live. Either way, now the enemy team has 4 people dead while my Urgot is just freely pushing mid. Notice this entire game, I didn't roam, I didn't go to dragon, I didn't help a jungle fight, I didn't TP into a play with my ult down or make a TP play in general since they could just run away, I didn't try to help my teammates, I didn't do anything other than stick to my win condition. Alright guys, sadly I can't go through every win condition of every champion of every game, especially since it can change depending on the game. But if you can realize your win condition and stick to it, your chances of winning drastically go up.
Now, what you find here on YouTube is just the tip of the iceberg. If you want to unlock your true potential, then you need to dive into SkillCapped.com. We have the largest catalog of League of Legends guides in the entire world, with over 1,500 guides and 350 unique courses. You get brand new guides every week exclusive to our website, along with our Smurf commentaries where our challenger experts walk you through how to carry out of the exact rank you're stuck in. Still unsure? Well, you can have all your questions answered by those same challenger experts. Need one-on-one coaching? We got you covered with hand-picked coaches trained to the highest standard. Don't have time for that? Use Direct Pro, pick a past game you played, and within 24 hours get a personalized video from a top 100 challenger player breaking down exactly what you can do better. The best part, all of this comes with a rank improvement guarantee. If you don't climb at least 5 divisions while actively using SkillCapped, you can claim a refund, no questions asked. So what are you waiting for? Head to SkillCapped.com and get the rank you've always wanted, link in the description below.
But that's going to bring us to the end of this one. We hope you enjoyed it, and thanks for watching.